Are you okay to be at the piano? Hey, ladies, let's come in.
Do you want my full intro, or
what?
Do you want my full...
No, just give them that C, and we'll see. Okay, ready? people can raise their hands and give a suggestion, right or wrong.
Come on.
Yes.
Within, I think it would be good as we're stepping down to gradually get quieter.
Good.
Okay.
Yes.
So on the same within, like I think we can go within, like big, and then bring it down.
Good. I like that because obviously it tells you that we are recounting, right? But the shape that we want to make definitely needs to have that peak, right? Within, it's not just going to pull back, right? Okay. What about before that? Because that's a good place to focus. Anybody in the room?
No, I think like when we start out with wind, we should like push it like start up strong.
Good. Okay, we're talking about shape. Alright. We're talking about shape. Okay? And we are doing this. Let's just speak it in time. Okay? Can you guys show me what we should do? Okay, so when?
When the world.
So you already have a sense of what you want to do, and I think that can show more in using it. Okay? Just do when the world closes in. I think that if we kind of close in a little bit and feel that, then that will kind of help show that. And then you already are doing the there, so showing that. When the world closes in, feel the stillness. I think the S, it's dangerous to say this, but I want you to lean on that a little bit more. Feel the stillness. Just try it. Might not work, but that's what's great about it.
Okay.
Energy. Eternal Cosmos. But stillness. Try it. It's less the beginning of the S and more like the stillness. You hear like the pause after it. Still going to keep going. Right? That the cutoff of the end stops the sound, but it could keep going. It's not going to die. Okay? Has all that potential. Yeah. Just feel the stillness. Everything comes from a sense of release and naturalness. Why it might feel like it isn't that way is because our posture is bad. Right? What is our normal posture when we're not like this? Show me hands. Okay. So if you're looking at me in the profile, it's just kind of very slouchy. Okay. Pair of pages. So, if I'm facing like this, fix my posture, how am I going to do? What?
No.
Yeah.
hot chip. Okay, so we can go out on top forever. Okay. Basically, this is what I like to do. I like to kind of go towards the tenth place and then back. Okay. So obviously this is bad. Okay, so chest lift is kind of a match the string. You guys have tried that, haven't you? So just imagine that there's like a string attached to the top of your cage and you pull it, okay? And that's sort of what's helping you lift. Obviously you can do, go too much like I was doing, right? Basically, you just want it to feel lifted enough first. And it might be up first, okay? I think you guys are probably used to it enough that it's not going to be too uncomfortable. Okay, shoulders. Sometimes, if I'm having trouble with that, I just like to actually all the way up where it is tense, okay? And then just drop. Yes, you won't roll back, but you can, it's possible to roll back too much, okay? So I like to even just kind of do this. It also helps me with like muscle pain, too, because I think probably you guys are also used to a lot of tension right here, okay? It's usually because these guys are doing too much, okay? So usually it's focused on your front delts and making sure that those are really stiff and free and not tense, rather than focusing here, okay? And that's the whole other discussion, okay? But I will actually like to focus that way, okay? So rolling your shoulders back is good because it will just kind of put you in the place it needs to be, okay? And then I just like to just kind of let them go where they feel like they're back, okay? But I'm not necessarily trying to hold them, right? Good. Okay, so feet, shoulder width apart, that's good, okay? Whatever our knees doing. Why do we give them supplements? Right. You guys know all that. Okay. So what about like hips and where everything is going?
We like everything together.
Yeah. That's the best way to say it. Everything's just kind of stacked on top of each other. Okay. What about our neck and head? So one of the best ways to do it is, because you guys know where you're supposed to put them, okay? But again, we don't want it to feel like, oh, I'm putting it here, I'm holding it here, it's tense, right? We're trying to release all of that. So knowing where it goes will also just kind of give them some freedom. So I will like to kind of position myself where I want to be, and also just be able to kind of do this, move around, and feel like it's not rigid. But just try that. Go to where your head is supposed to feel. Kind of go side to side. Just kind of feeling like it can move, okay? I'll do that while I'm singing, like while I'm practicing, okay? Because if there's things happening here, if we're tensing up in our neck or like right over, it's going to be a little harder to kind of do it, right? Do that. And you're also just really aware, okay? So that's something I'm kind of nice to explore, okay? While we're talking about posture, about breath. What do I need to do that for? Use your eyes. What? Say that again.
Low breaths.
What does that mean?
Low breath.
But that's where our lungs are. I like to just think about something. Okay. Obviously, singing is a very natural thing. Sometimes we talk about things. Actually make like anatomical sense, because yes, our voice box is actually here. That's the thing making sense. We almost want to not think about that at all. Like that's sort of the goal. Is you want to think about everything else helping you sing and actually think more about just the release rather than control. Okay. And that's sort of what advancing here will do. Okay. So if we're breathing low and in our stomach, how should we approach that? Yes.
That was a voice lesson. My voice teacher loves how you can imagine the energy around you and kind of fill up.
I really like that. Okay? There's lots of different ways you can do that. You can think of a balloon, inner tube. I like things like that because it's a 360-degree version of it rather than just here. Right? It's not just at this point. It's all around. Okay? So everyone try this. Just hands right under the page. Okay? What's hard about it? You'll have a hard time getting the breathing right, is that you're actually not feeling enough up in your cage as you fill up your air. Okay.
So as you're finding posture before you breath, you want to have a little bit of all breath. If I'm like, that's when I can have tension, that's when I can have it. Okay, it's already open. Okay. And then as I feel in my stomach, I'm all when I was first trying to do this, I would feel like I wasn't getting enough air. Anyone feel like if they try to breathe in their stomach, they're not getting enough air?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's because I was thinking just here. I was feeling just stomach, and then I wasn't feeling nothing. You have to do both at the same time. Okay? Go straight back to that. And then breathe in 8 counts, and breathe out 8 counts. Okay, ready? And in. 1, 2, what we want to be wary of, right? Is if it does feel like we're like, okay, use the abs, use the stomach, right? Then that's what we're doing. Yeah, it does help you.
I know I'm doing it wrong, I feel this, but so I have a tendency to like feel it in my stomach, and then like I'm trying to do it at the same time, but I end up like, but I have myself, okay, push it up to my chest,
mm-hmm.
so I run out of breath faster.
Yeah.
That's the fun
part. Yeah, that's a normal thing, okay? And it, why is just because we just grow up with different inhibitions. What's an inhibition? What? Yeah, good. Something blocking you from communication, okay? What I liked, my idea of singing in general, is that you're just born knowing how to do already. Okay? Think about a baby crying. What can they do?
Cry.
It's like they already have that sound, they don't have to think about it. Okay, you just do it. Okay? And then sort of as you grow up, then you have the tension sort of placed upon you. Okay? And you forget how to breathe normally. Okay. Have you ever lied on the floor and breathe?
Yes.
Okay, what happens when you do that? Where do you feel like the breathing happens the most?
I feel like it almost forces you to like
walk. Yeah. Yeah, what I like to do is lie on the floor and just not even think about how to breathe correctly. Just breathe. Your body naturally knows how to do it. Why do you think that works when you're on the floor? Huh? Yes. Okay, so our body's naturally doing it. So but why is it naturally doing it correctly?
Because we're like, our whole system is supported on the floor compared to when we're standing.
Exactly. Yeah, you have to support yourself when you're standing, but like when you're on the floor, then the floor is doing all the work. That's just good. Right? Have you ever lied in your stomach? Okay, what happens there? Well, I'm just hearing just whispers. Kind of lie on your stomach and just kind of have your head to the side and give all your weight again. And don't try to think about breathing as much. It's going to feel a little different, maybe not as correct. Okay, your stomach will feel like it's going into the floor, but also your back will rise. Why is that? Does it only happen when you're lying on your stomach though?
Mm-hmm.
are you all the time? Okay, that's just a one way that we can notice them. And why is because those muscles are just involved for everything. Okay, just really open breathing. Why? So obviously the answer to why do we want to breathe like this is because it's natural. Okay, but why else?
More air.
More air. How's it just like we say it? More support.
More breath control.
Definitely. Okay. Just because our posture's bad, we just need that air. Like I was working on with the outros, it's not, it's energy, it's not also like if you don't have the breath to do that, then you're not going to be able to give that. Right? Good. Okay. So I want you to, now that we've done this, okay, let's do this again. I like doing this because you have your hands in contact with your full body so you can actually feel the back doing the work just as fast. Let's try it again. Breathe in 8 counts, out 8 counts. Okay. I'll do it with you, so I'll just say in and out. Ready and in. We feel the back and then some more fits. So what is our root case supposed to do as we breathe out?
Compress.
Huh?
Compress.
Decompress?
Compress. It's kind of like deflates kind of.
Okay. Any other idea? Good. If we again think about it as rigid or held, then that's kind of What can I contribute to? Yeah, tension. Anywhere, not necessarily here. It can all be referred. Okay, refer pain, refer tension is the same idea. Sometimes if you have a tension in one place, it's not usually the cause, just there. Okay. Sometimes it can be somewhere else. Okay, so back to the anger. Okay. So I don't want you to think of the back that is completely held or rigid. Because then it's going to do some moving. Think about how it's going to be completely still, and that's when you're going to get frustrated, but also it just has no tension. Okay? So now we're going to try it this way, where you have your hand behind your chest. And we're just going to be self-conscious. What we're doing, it just is what it is. It just goes out. Okay? So you breathe in. Okay? And what I want you to do is just focus on keeping it lifted. Don't try to focus on putting more air here. Just focus on breathing low, okay? I like to think all the way out like this. I breathe in, okay? And I breathe out, and it is going to go in like this, okay? But here's a trick. When you breathe out, I want you to think about breathing this way, so not in. So you breathe out, or if you breathe in, and you breathe out. You're gonna go down both times, okay? Ready? Breathe in. Think down. Breathe out. Think down. Breathe in. Down low. Breathe out. Down. Okay, what are some things that we notice? Whether it's working or not. Yeah.
Oh, when I breathed out, I felt more relaxed and also.
Good, I like that. Yes? Yeah, the expansion.
Not as much effort is required to fill one thing.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. You're focusing on other things. Alright, we're focusing on that energy, completely low and down. That helps us just do what we're supposed to do, while also giving us enough what we need. Okay? What else? Anything else? Good. Okay. So that's a really nice thing that we can start to kind of focus on is we're kind of feeling down all the time. Right? Just because we're going out doesn't mean go in, squeeze in. I want you to think out. It's that release effort all the time. Okay? Okay. So, what about face or head posture? That's what I can call it. Okay. So we already talked about like what it's looking like in breath posture. What about here? Okay. What does that do?
It's open. It makes
good or expressive.
Is there any danger to that? Huh? Exactly. What? How do you think you could go too far? Good. That's a danger. What else? Yeah.
I think that if you raise them too high and you're putting effort into that, it could cause tension in your face.
Exactly. Okay. So that's just something that we need to be aware of. I think that's fine as long as that we're aware of what you're doing too much, because if you're raising too much, you're putting too much effort for tensions, right? It's gonna be creeping into other places. Okay? We just want that release. Okay, great. So we talked about that. What else in this area? Exactly. Good. So a nice release kind of feeling. Yeah.
Lift your soft palate.
Yes. How do we do that? Yeah. There's lots of different ways that you can describe it. Okay. Yawning is good because that's the space we want, but obviously we don't want to complete a yawn. Okay. I like to do the inverted K. You know, have we done that before? So it's basically like if you say, but then you breathe in and do that. Okay, so as we do that, let's try to do it all at once. Ready? Okay, what do we notice? I want you to try to do it not as sharp, so listen, not, but just kind of, not really trying to make the sound, but just kind of feeling that rush of cool air instead, rather than making the sound. Let's try it. Ready? Okay. What do we notice?
So, like, you can feel it opening, and also, like, my tongue kind of, I don't know exactly how to describe it, but it kind of, like, lifts a little bit, too.
Okay.
And it just, like, allows for more space.
Definitely. Yeah, so basically, you kind of answer what I was going to maybe suggest after that. It's like, why? Yeah, and that's the thing, yawning, and it's okay. Like, if people yawn in my voice lessons when we're working on this kind of thing, it's like, I'm not mad because it's actually opening up the space they need to use, so maybe they're not even okay. Good. So, yeah, it gives that space. Why do we need that space? Resonance. Okay, good. What's resonance?
It's like that opening, like, I'm not sure if I'm...